Well, good morning, everybody. This is Dear Mama Sal, and it's a very drizzly 6 degrees here in Vancouver, and it is 42. For those of you who don't understand Canadian temperatures. All right, so first of all, a big apology to everybody who thinks I didn't put up a vlog yesterday. I did, but I put it up privately, and the reason was that it was Sorry, somebody was trying to cross the road. I needed to concentrate. I put it up privately because it was one of those vlogs where I accidentally hit Super Zoom, and I don't know how I do that. And it's obviously a trick that I have developed and cultivated, and I'm extremely good at. Anything was, I didn't notice it. And so I did the whole of the vlog yesterday looking at the pores of my skin. So I didn't think that would be very entertaining for everybody, although I did have a subject matter on it that was very important to at least one of my viewers. They particularly asked me to talk on a subject, so I did. And for the subject that I spoke about, in case anybody's feeling they lost out, was etiquette around using your cell phone when you're visiting other people. And it had other things on it as well, obviously, because, you know, it was my morning ramblings on my way to work, and you know that that normally covers a lot of subjects. So if any of you really would like to see the vlog, I'm not stopping anybody from watching it at all. I just need you to let me have your just write me a note to dearmamasal@gmail.com or a private note on the Facebook page, whichever you prefer, and give me your email address, and I will put your name onto the private section, which means that you can go in there and watch it. So everybody gets to watch it if they want to. I just thought it was one too many boo-boo for me in terms of broadcast quality. So there's a difference between being a doofus and then just consistently putting up garbage. And that's how I felt about it yesterday. So, however, I know at least some of you have watched it and some of you have made some comments about it, so obviously it helped you. So that's good to hear. It is New Year's Eve. It's New Year's Day for those of you in Australia and so forth. And by the time you watch this, it will be New Year's Day everywhere. So happy New Year's Day, everybody. And let's make this year a better year, in whatever way you'd like it to be better. And in those terms, I really want to just recap some of the things that we keep talking about, and I will continue to keep talking about, because they change your day every day. Decide what sort of day you want to have. If you have decided that you're going to have a good day, then you will not let the idiots get you down. Because as they do things to really get up your nerves, you will just go, excuse me, I'm not going to give you power over my day. I've decided to have a good day. That's the number one thing. Every single day, decide you're going to have a good day. Give yourself the mojo, right, the mojo juice to be able to fight off the negativity of the day. And you remember what they always say, you know, which is, you know, don't walk away from a negative person, run. Right? Because negative people will drain your spirit. They really will. They will drain you if you spend too much time around them. So ration the amount of time you spend around negative people. And if people can't be bothered to get control of their own brains, you know what I mean, in terms of their attitude, then you don't have to put up with it, right? You just need to get away from that. Doesn't mean you have to be... this stupids are up today, people. Seriously. The stupids are out today. This trucky thing in ahead of me has got some bozo in it that was heading straight for the center median. And luckily, at the last moment, noticed that. I have no idea where this person's mind was at, but it sure as heck was not driving cars. He was just like, hello? What are you doing? So I think I need to keep a watchful eye out on the stupids now. That's two. And I've only been on the road less than 10 minutes. could be a fascinating ride in. All right, where was I? Okay, so protect your space. Do you know what I mean? Protect your mentality. Definitely be aware of what happens. Now, if you get yourself into a funk, you know that the best thing you can possibly do is something creative. Something that will bring you achievement. Those are the two things. For some reason, those two things, in my book anyway, bring about some heavy mojo juice, otherwise known as serotonin. You know, it really does pump up your ability to see things in a better way. So, some of you will get creative and get achievement as well. But the thing is this, that you can be creative and produce absolutely nothing, and that's okay. Because if you've been doing something creative, then it still has the same effect. As long as you keep your sense of humor. So, you know, if you are not a great painter, but you actually just fancy painting, just go ahead and do it. And by the way, some of you are going, oh, well, I don't have paint. I don't have so-and-so. Well, I'm a great make a plan person, as you know. And so for those of you who maybe got some house paint in the garage or something, or are hidden away somewhere, use house paint. Works really well. Believe me, I know. I do most of my paintings with house paint. So, you know, just have fun. I know some of you are housebound at the moment because of the weather. There's some really serious weather going on. So have some fun. Bring out the kid in you for a little while today. And bring out the kid in you a little while this year. The other thing I keep repeating in different ways is stop waiting for somebody else to make you happy. It's not going to happen. One of the interesting things about people who live on their own is they are either miserable or they're happy as a clam. And the, you know, you've got to be somebody who can entertain yourself. It's not somebody else's job to make you happy. Too many of us, and I say this to the young people as well, you know, don't think that getting married is going to make you happy. Only you can make you happy. If you're not capable of making yourself happy on your own, getting married is not going to make you happy. You're just going to resent your husband for not making you happy. And the reason you're not going to be happy is because you're a miserable person. Do you know what I mean? It's like, stop waiting for somebody else to make you happy. Do whatever it takes to make yourself happy, and you'll be a happier person to be around. And have a look at that. Are you a nice person to be around? Do people enjoy being around you? If so, you've probably got friends. If you haven't got friends, it's probably because you don't share enough of yourself. You're probably quite selfish in some ways. So I'm a great believer in, have a look at your life, every hour of every day, and go, you know, has the last hour all been about me, or is it about other people? Am I reaching out and doing things for other people, or am I doing all this just for myself? Make yourself a happy person by making other people happy. Of course, if you make other people happy and resent it, I'm going to phone people up now and pretend to be happy. I mean, who are you kidding? You think they don't hear that in your voice? Yeah, such is life. But it's going to be a good year. I know it's going to be a good year. You know, it was really strange to look back on the year that I've had as Dear Mama Sal, and to really reflect on the fact that I have totally changed my way of life, thanks to you guys. And it's really quite funny how many of you you know, just seem to communicate on a very different level now, a real friendship level, which is delightful to me. What I did say in yesterday's vlog, and in case you don't send me an email, I would like to repeat this today, and I probably repeated it a couple of times. This is about the fact that some of the viewers, and it's always difficult because, you know, I've got some viewers that are very, very regular viewers, and they will tell me what they want, and I just want to make sure that it's, I'm not running a website that pleases, you know, a dozen people. I would like to make sure that it pleases a lot more than that. And so one of the things that they were talking about is they'd love to see me do some product reviews, and as only I can, of course. And so I'd like to get some feedback for those of you who are both regular viewers and maybe occasional viewers. Would you like to see that? Is that something that you would like to see? And if so, what sort of things would you like me to to review? I know some of you want to see me do my makeup, for example, which of course makes me chuckle, but I'll gladly do it. I guess we'd call it the Dear Mama Sal signature look. I will gladly do that, and I intend to do that over the next little while. And some of you are really interested in the products that I use on my skin, which fascinated me. And that will probably shock you. But I'm prepared to do that as well. And so we really, what I need is some ideas about what you'd like me to do. How many of you, for example, enjoy the day trips or whatever I do when I go away? And what is it you enjoy about them? Just so that I know that I'm putting in the right things. And I know that some of you enjoyed the Doofus cooking reports, and that's, I will continue to try and put some of those in occasionally as well. So that's fun for me to do every now and then. because I really... I hadn't realised, in fact, until I started doing this, that I actually do cook. When I say I do cook, you know, I cook by the seat of my pants, but I do cook. And I did a stir fry last night. And it was totally simple to do. I literally took some of the fresh vegetables I had in my fridge. I always keep a packet of what I call oriental mix type frozen vegetables, because it normally has some vegetables in it that I wouldn't have in my fridge. And I mixed those up with some leftover vegetables from my freezer. And I sort of, you know, in equal quantities, so I had a sort of nice mix of each. And then I took a chicken breast on my George Foreman grill. And then after I cooked the chicken breast, I soaked the chicken breast in a pre-made mixture of, I think I had prune sauce, Worcestershire sauce, soy sauce. Something. I wonder what the something was. Worcestershire sauce. Maybe it was just those. Oh, sorry. Yeah, soy sauce is there. Anyway, and I just soaked that the meat in there and then put it over the vegetables. It was really tasty. And quite filling and quite healthy. Well, except for the sauce, maybe. But I did one chicken breast between two of us. That's what I'm learning, by the way, for those of you who are trying to eat more healthily. I eat half as much meat as I used to, literally. So if I used to have a full steak, I now eat half a steak. I used to have a full chicken breast, I now eat half a chicken breast. And that, to me, allows me to have meat almost every day. Because my consumption of meat is half of what I would normally have. And I'm just trying to think what I've done for tonight. Oh, tonight I'm having shepherd's pie. Now, there's another trick for those of you who know shepherd's pie. That's ground meat with some vegetables in it, all ground up and covered in mashed potato. But what I did is I put it all in, pre-cooked it all, and then threw it in my stock pot overnight, so that all the flavors of all the different, the meat and the vegetables and everything else, all interspersed, and by the time I put it together tonight, you know, it'll have a really good all-over taste to it, rather than sort of individual tastes. Really hard work. I took whatever vegetables I had left over after the stir fry, put them in my magic bullet, and chopped them up, and did about very slightly more meat than vegetables. But again, you understand, try and get a sort of equal split of vegetables and meat, because then it is far more healthy. In the old days, it would have been 100% meat. Well, now, yeah, except for maybe some onions or something. So now I put onions and carrots and as many vegetables as I think will be, celery, you know, whatever. In fact, I took a tremendous cross-section of vegetables to make it yesterday. And my buddy at work took my parking space this morning. And it's not because somebody had taken hers either. That's quite funny. This is Dear Mama Sal saying, I'm off to work. See you later.